Officers say they were protecting themselves, but this man says he thought he was going to die.
Man, I'm getting tears thinking about it. I mean, you know, I don't even want to watch the tape of them beating me because I get upset.
Tonight in a Defenders exclusive, what led to this violent arrest in Inkster.
Good evening, and thanks for joining us for Local 4 News at 11. The video is graphic and pretty tough to watch. Two Inkster police officers make a traffic stop, and what happens next has led to a state investigation.
Were police really protecting themselves, or is it a simple case of brutality? Defender Kevin Dietz joins us from the Inkster Police Station with the video. Kevin.
We all know being a police officer is a difficult and dangerous job. It's also one that requires integrity and honesty. Tonight, a very disturbing video with two very different stories about what this video shows. Take a look. You're looking at police dash cam video, a traffic stop of 57-year-old Floyd Dent, who is driving his Cadillac in the city of Inkster. When he's pulled over by police, he opens his car door. The situation immediately escalates and then turns violent. According to police reports and court testimony, Inkster police officer Melendez puts Dent in a chokehold and then delivers 16 blows to his head. A second officer, Zielinski, struggles to handcuff Dent. A third officer, Kritzers, runs up and tasers Dent three times, twice in the stomach, once in the leg. Several Michigan State police officers respond as backup and are also on scene. Police say they were protecting themselves. Dent says he doesn't know why he was pulled over or why he was viciously beaten.
Next thing I know, he officer brought up to me with his gun, you know, talking about blowing my head off. Then he grabbed me out the car, you know, and started beating on me. You know, I just couldn't believe it.
Police say they first saw Dent's car through binoculars. They were watching an area known for drug dealing. They followed Dent's car and say he did not properly stop at a stop sign. They say when they turned on their overhead lights, Dent did not pull over immediately, and they believed he was fleeing the officers.
When overhead lights came on, I looked, I said, wow, are they stopping me?
Dent says he did not try and flee, and the video shows he drove at a consistent speed until pulling over across the street from the old police station.
I had pulled over and opened my car door, had my hands out.
When the car door opened, the police say they ordered Dent to put his hands up, but they could only see one of his hands. They say Dent yelled at the officers, I'll kill you. The officers' microphones were either turned off or not working. There is no audio of the alleged threat. Greg Roll is Dent's attorney.
You have six responding vehicles, and not one officer is equipped with a microphone to take down this alleged threat.
On the ground, police say Dent refused to put his hands behind his back. Dent said he thought he was being choked to death and tried to pull the officer's arm from his throat. The officer says Dent bit him on the arm, and that's why he started punching. They say the 16 blows to the head, a kick to the arm, and three taser blasts were necessary to protect themselves while restraining Dent. The officer, who says he was bit, did not seek medical attention or photograph his injuries.
I'm lucky to be living, you know, because I think they were trying to kill me, especially when they had choked me, you know. I mean, I was on my last breath. I had told the officer, please, I can't breathe.
Dent was not armed and no gun was found in his car. After the arrest, police discovered Dent was driving on a suspended license. They also say they found a baggie of crack cocaine under the passenger seat.
They planted that stuff in my car, believe me.
Dent has been working for Ford Motor Company for 37 years and has no criminal record. He had his blood tested at the hospital and had no drugs in his system. Officer Melendez, the one seen throwing the punches, is the same officer who, when working as a Detroit police officer in 2003, was charged by the U.S. Attorney's Office with planting evidence and falsifying reports. A jury found Officer Melendez not guilty.
I worked for my, you know, I've been in my job 37 years, you know, so, you know, I don't have to sell drugs, you know, I don't sell drugs. You know, and don't do drugs.
Floyd Dent is African American. His attorney says the three officers who made physical contact with Dent and seven more who arrived as backup are all white, and that concerns him.
In this type of climate, it's just remarkable that things are this slow go on. It's amazing. It amazes me. And it's shocking. disturbing.
A judge looked at the video and dismissed multiple charges, saying there is no evidence that Dent was fleeing and eluding police officers, no evidence that Dent was resisting arrest, and no evidence that Dent assaulted any police officers. Inkster Police launched an investigation immediately and asked the Michigan State Police to investigate as well. Officer Melendez is off the street working a desk job pending the outcome of the investigations.
The Inkster Police Department has a policy in line with best practices that requires that any significant use of force or serious use of force resulting in injury requires an internal investigation. That I was notified that night of the prisoner going to the hospital, and the investigation was ordered immediately, and it's ongoing at this time.
Man, I'm getting tears thinking about it. I mean, you know, I don't even want to watch the tape of them beating me, because I get upset.
While most of the charges have been thrown out, Floyd Dent still faces possession of cocaine charges, and he has a court date on April the 1st. He was offered a plea deal where he would receive probation for that charge. He refused that deal, saying he will not plead guilty to a crime he did not commit. Kevin Dietz, Defenders.
Well, Kevin, I know you've been talking to people in the community there, too, about this video. How are they reacting to it?
Yeah, there's going to be a lot of talk about this video. So far, the people we've talked to said they want to wait and see what the investigation finds. But others are planning a protest for that April 1st court date. They say they want to let the police chief know exactly how they feel about what they see on the video.
All right. Well, Kevin, let's point out that Kevin's investigation is not over. Tomorrow, during our Local 4 News at 5, he's going to take a closer look at these previous allegations made against the officer seen throwing the punches. You'll also hear from family members of the driver who say they are still fearful. That's tomorrow afternoon on Local 4 News at 5.